Boy, I'm live. Well, that's embarrassing.
Got it.
Am I coming in clear? Hooray. Music coming in clear as well. Half past seven here? No, I'm on the West Coast, man. It is half past eight. Hey, Mike! All right, let's pop this chat out. YouTube is not receiving enough video to maintain smooth streaming. Well then. Because apparently it doesn't like me doing this. Hola! Welcome into the jungle. Oh yeah. There's no doubt about that. Aloha everyone. Also, look what I learned how to do. I learned how to change things. I also can do this. Isn't that fun? Yeah, seriously. I don't think so. I honestly don't think so. Yeah, still no J World date. I have heard work walls will be coming down today, but my Smash predictions, okay, I was going to do this like years ago before they announced even the first round of, like, the first round of DLC. I am.
Hello, stream.
here is Zach without a shirt.
No, they can't.
But I was gonna make this video like years ago and say like Crash, Minecraft Steve. It's a long shot, but because they have a working relationship with Microsoft, maybe Master Chief. Because dang it, I want an ultimate battle between all of the console mascots. I want it. But we'll see. Yeah. Godzilla for Smash. Okay, he's too big. Godzilla.
But Godzuki.
That's true. Godzuki. Yeah. Someone in the chat said Godzuki too. Got my Smash dream with Simon Belmont. Sames. Doom guy got a better shot than Matt. Yeah, a little bit. Because there's probably more of a poor Patuna for Smash. I have seen Godzilla King of the Monsters. I'm working on the monster vlog right now. Maybe Sans. I don't know. That's Papyrus. Figment for Smash. I'd be down for that. Again, I don't think Banjo's gonna do it, though. Because, okay, Shantae probably has a better chance. Birdo, hey, maybe. Cuphead, I don't think so. Because I don't think Cuphead would really work in that art style.
Darth Vader,
yeah. Battle for Bikini Bottom Remaster. Yep. Yeah, what I'm really expecting from this particular Direct, yes, we're probably going to get some... I mean, more than likely, we're going to get the next round of Smash DLC announcements. A little bit more information on... Yeah, Banjo would probably be a Duck Hunt Echo. A little bit more information on Link's Remakening. Possibly an update on Metroid Prime 4. Because we haven't heard hide or hair of that since they announced it was delayed. What else? I've heard conflicting reports on whether or not we'd be getting Animal Crossing info. I don't know. Overwatch Switchport, eh. Monster the Unlikely. Think they'll talk about Super Nintendo World? Yeah, probably not. When we get closer to an announcement or like a reveal for it, maybe. Maybe. Metroid Prime Trilogy Remastered? Yeah, definitely. I mean, that goes without saying. Also, can we talk about how limited run games is just going to make me absolutely broke? Because limited run games announced a ton of stuff yesterday. They announced Double Switch. The old Sega CD game would be coming to Switch. They announced Corpse Killer was getting a release for PS4. They announced, what else? Night in the Woods was getting a physical release for Switch. And a bunch of Lucasfilm games. Like, Star Wars Lucasfilm games. So this E3 is going to put me in the red. I don't think we're going to get a new Pokemon Mystery Dungeon this close to Sword and Shield. Three stuff. Yeah, probably. Sword and Shield starter. To be perfectly honest, I was leaning toward God, what's his name? The monkey one. I was leaning toward that one. And then Swabble was revealed. Or Sobble. I don't know why I called him Swabble. Yeah, I'm Sobble Squad. Sorry. Sobble and Wooloo! Wooloo! In fact, this is now a Wooloo stand stream.
Master of the fields of England and king of the fluffs.
Corviknight, yeah. Thank you, Clark, for the buck 99. Battle for Bikini Bottom rehydrated. Yeah, that's already been announced for the Switch. Like, that's not even a thing. Bye, 100! That's a name I haven't seen in a while. But yeah, we stand Wooloo. Beep, beep, I'm a sheep, motherfucker. Oh god, what was his name? Dreadnought. The snapping turtle. I thought that was pretty cool. What game would I like to see remastered? Oh geez. I know we're getting Ghostbusters later this year, so that's fun. And giving me an excuse to, you know, finish that. I want a physical edition of the Phoenix Wright games. Honestly, Universal Studios Theme Park Adventure remaster. We need it. We do. Luigi's Mansion 3 info. We are definitely going to be getting some VR theme park adventure. Oh, jeez. Would the camera transitions be just as bad? All right, how much longer do we have on this guy? Apparently, it's saying they're live. Jenny Nicholson for Smash. Her final smash is just sitting on her bed yelling, "Where's the boy?" Oh, Hit and Run would definitely be a good remaster. Yeah, Orlando's Third Gate, Fantastic Worlds. Oh boy. Oh boy. I don't think we're gonna. Well, we might get a GTA game on Switch. Like, LA Noire really paved the way for that. The only good way to tweak Fast and Furious Supercharged is to burn it to the ground and salt the earth. That is literally the only way to tweak Supercharged. And I will maintain, I'll explain this in video, but Florida got the better deal with Supercharged. It's better in Florida. What else could they build there besides Nintendo Land? Rumors are suggesting a Fantastic Beasts area. And if nothing else comes along that's better, a Classic Monsters land. And that would make me want to book a trip to Florida immediately. I'm not going to explain the Supercharged thing now. That would be ruining the surprise. more than likely Crash. I don't think Spyro, although four-legged characters definitely can work. Could a Fast and Furious ride work? It could if it didn't suck. Like, I don't know, if they just didn't make it a outright clone of King Kong. Okay, here's the thing about Super Nintendo World. Super Nintendo World, like, if it had, like, a Splatoon ride, it would need a Splatoon area. Yeah, Magical New York or Paris. Definitely not going to get any Pokemon news because we just got that direct with Wooloo! Oh, no, 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 no. Let's say they open with Luigi's Mansion or Smash. No, they're probably going to save Smash for probably midpoint or the end. Because that's what they know that everybody is waiting for. Yes! Adventures in the Magic Kingdom! Absolutely. I still need to watch the Grumps playthrough with, God, what's his name? Ben Schwartz. Yes, I got there. Give me ideas for Minecraft theme park land. Don't fall. Woo-hoo! Sorry. Ben Schwartz, voice of Sonic the Hedgehog. All right, but we are a minute away, so... Music's gonna go away. And we are heading over here. Am I still coming in clear? Hello? Ah! You guys gonna do anything Galaxy's Edge related when your pass opens again? Yeah, go. We are definitely going to go. All right, I got 9 a.m. Yo! Oh, God! Oh, God, here we go, here we go, here we go. Audio coming in good? What? Starting with Smash. Epona for Smash? What? Wait. Okay, is it a Dragon Age dude? Yeah, it's a Dragon Age guy. All right. Oh yeah. Well, hey, at least it's not a friggin' Fire Emblem character, but it's another sword wield. So this is only mildly disappointing. Dragon Quest! Not Dragon Age.
Thank you for the correction.
If this is literally the rest of the DLC, I'm pissed. Okay, so... No, they're all Dragon Quest. Or, like, different costumes. What? Okay, so they play completely differently from one another. Or not, I don't know. Oh, that's a fun final smash. Dragon Quest 11. Jeez. Echoes? Summer 2019. Yeah. And Dragon Quest 11. Yeah, I guess. Patrick saying, "Who are you people?" Yeah, this is the closest we're getting for Goku and Smash, so there you go. It's like, whatever, I got the fighter pass, so it's whatever, it's fine. Feel like a complete waste of money. Wait, we're getting the character before we're getting the game.
Hello everyone, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi from Nintendo. In this Nintendo Direct for E3 2019, we'll showcase a variety of games, many of them coming soon. But before we dig into the next game, there is someone I'd like to introduce first. What? What are you doing here?
Oh. Get it?
Wait. Wait a minute. There's been a bit of a mix-up. You're not the right Bowser. Sorry, but I'm the right Bowser for this presentation.
I forgot that Reggie was gone.
Right,
not this
cute.
Way.
No. This way.
Bye-bye.
Maybe next time.
All right, that
Are
was
you
cute.
Related?
No, but we get that a lot.
Well, let's get back to it. Please, take it away.
Hi, everyone. I'm Doug Bowser from Nintendo of America, and I'm thrilled to join you for today's Nintendo Direct. This is our chance to show the world we have games for every type of player on Nintendo Switch. Whether you love action, RPGs, or you're just looking for something new, we've got you covered.
Okay, so let's get a look at one of those games by taking a tour. of Luigi's Mansion 3.
Yeah! Luigi's Mansion 3.
Hello?
God.
Mario.
That's a hotel!
Luigi's invited to a gorgeous hotel with Mario, Peach, and the others. Oh, lucky him.
The scariest.
Luigi's Mansion 3. This hotel is much more than meets the eye, for not long after Luigi arrives, things take a dark turn. We begin our tour by taking in some sights and sounds. You may never leave. You want to leave. The other guests certainly don't plan to move on. They're ghosts after all, and they're rather aggressive. Simply scare them with the strobe bulb, then suck them up. Luigi's new Poltergust G00 has the powerful suction capabilities required, and other new features as well. First, the slam. While trapping a ghost, slam it on the ground to inflict some damage. It helps to get other ghosts in on the action. Next,
stop that
shot. Fire the plunger to attach it to something, then pull the string and you can
pull the string
furniture and more. It's effective against certain ghost types too.
That's cool.
Sometimes ghosts may feel inclined to gang up on you. In such situations, a burst should do. The powerful air pressure released will blow away ghosts, and it's perfect for when you need a little air. We simply can't overlook the latest invention from Professor Egad, namely Gooigi. Change between Luigi and Gooigi to use both their skills. Gooigi can do everything from slipping through metal fences
to
walking on spikes. Indeed, there are obstacles too great for Luigi to handle on his own. And if you pass a Joy-Con controller to a friend, he makes for a great co-op partner. But proceed with caution. Gooigi and water definitely don't mix. Now, please direct your attention to the Scare Scraper. Spooky? Sure. Yet it also houses up to 8 players for local or online co-op gameplay. Defeat all ghosts before time runs out. Seek and find our dear misplaced toads. And face any challenges the tower throws at you together.
Yeah, but you need a Nintendo.
Place to wake up in, a haunted hotel with floor after floor of oddities. Many traps and mischievous ghosts lurk within. What will befall our missing Mario and friends and his dear brother Luigi?
Oh,
their fate rests in your hands. Luigi's Mansion 3.
Hey, it's another game available in 2019.
So that was Luigi's Mansion 3, the latest game in a series that I personally love. And we can look forward to seeing some of the new gameplay elements that await in this strange hotel as we dive deeper into this title on Nintendo Treehouse, live at E3 2019. We'll be streaming content, some you've never seen before, right from the show floor, including live gameplay of Super Mario Maker 2. And on day 3, our Treehouse staff will get their hands on some promising indie games that are new to Nintendo Switch. While you watch today's Nintendo Direct, keep an eye out for this icon to learn what other games will appear on Nintendo Treehouse live at E3 2019. You won't want to miss it. Or this. Have a look.
Dark Crystal?
Ogre slept too long. Far too long. Sing me your story. What has become of... No! What have they done? Avarice unchecked for an age. Evil takes root. Darkness spreads. But from this dark, light brighter than the three suns, they spark to life. Heroes of Thra.
Dark Crystal
strong
RPG.
And brave. Strength and bravery alone will not save Thra. No! Unlock your true potential. Unite as one! Only together can you defeat what is to come. Heroes of Thra. They're going to need all the help they can get.
Age of Resistance Tactics. Oh boy. Yay, remakening. I love this art style. Up with that fight. Oh, jeez. New art style. When? Today. That'd be amazing. Make your own dungeons. That's cool. September 20th. Wow, that's soon. Final Fantasy X. No, wait, didn't that just come out? No, it's not 10. Oh, like Crystal Chronicles or something like that.
RPG Trials of Mana is getting a global release
Trials
on Nintendo Switch.
Okay. Hey, look,
set
RPGs that I don't care about.
With the power of mana.
You kids have fun with these Trials
of
Mana. Trails of Mana. Mana. Early 2020. All right. Yeah, you have fun with that. The three games, Mana series, now available on Nintendo Switch. Whoa, Secret of Mana? Okay. Is this a new Game Freak game? No, no, it's not. Okay.
I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her?
Witcher.
Wow. That's a pull. Okay.
promised reunion of beloved students.
Let's all agree to meet back at the monastery exactly 5 years from today.
Like a class reunion?
You will come, won't you?
Think this is Fire Emblem?
Years ago, we fought here as classmates.
As big class reunions go, this one's gotta be the worst in history. What should we do, Teach?
Kill every last one of them!
Yeah! Kill them all!
Fire!
Here we go. Yeah. Again, you kids
still
have fun with this one.
We have no choice but to eliminate those who cling to unreasonable ideas of justice.
Someone must put a stop to this cycle of the strong trampling the weak.
The Soda Philistar consumes even the darkness itself.
Yet we have the strength to scale the walls between us, to reach out our hands in friendship so we can open our true hearts to one another. That's how we win!
My teacher.
Both sides of time revealed to you. What shall you do?
Like, Marth piqued my interest, but the continued support for Fire Emblem and Smash is just, ugh.
How lovely it would be for this moment to last forever.
Wow. Well, they announced that in, like, a previous
Nintendo Switch.
Nintendo Switch is the only gaming console you can play, not only on your TV at home, but anywhere you go. In fact, with a system like this, it might be fun to play Resident Evil at a location like this.
What?
This is perfect, right?
Yeah. What? Like, we're talking the first Resident Evil, right?
No lights?
No lights. Hey, over there.
Or is it RE4?
Okay. Let's do this.
Okay.
Resident Evil.
Yo!
Can you open it?
Try. See what's through there. Did it just eat him? It's gonna come back. Okay, 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 okay. Did I get it? I got it. Oh, I knew it.
Whoa! RE5? And RE6. Okay, the bad ones.
Resident Evil.
Wow. Yeah, don't forget your Switch, bro.
Playing a Resident Evil game in a place like that might not be my way to play, but I bet you could find your way to play, don't you think? For now, please take a look.
Was today the 4th of July? If not, is the Empire striking back or what? Looks like things are gonna get weird today.
Hey, she!
Oh, wait. This is that game that they announced in one of the directs. Okay.
As you can see, things got all funky real quick. There's probably some planet-eating type dude waiting for me up ahead. All yoked and powerful and trying to take over the world or something.
Oh, no, it's Travis. All right.
Don't you worry. A hero descends. What? There are no heroes in this world? Oh, but there totally are. My name is Travis Touchdown. I'm the last hero around. Here to save the world. I'm also just a passing assassin. Now let's do this. Start the game.
Officially No More Heroes 3.
Welcome back, Travis, to the Garden of Madness.
There we go.
This is Kaiser.
What?
He led an elite team of Contras during war.
Hungry Beast!
HB is actually a cyborg. I love him so much. This is Miss Harakiri and her alien gut bucket. They survived by merging together during the Alien Wars. The gentleman, the sweetest bug you'll ever meet.
You soiled my arm!
Is this a new Contra game? This looks like a new Contra game. Holy shit! Wow, that's a blast from the past there. Yes! Yes! Damon X Machina. Okay, here we go.
I have arrived.
Don't give up.
Begin the mission.
It's your call, rookie.
The battle's already started?
If you get in our way, we will eliminate you.
A new awakening draws nigh.
Okay, did anybody play, like, the beta test for this that they had for a while back? I never got a chance. It's still, like, downloaded on my Switch. I never played it. It looks awesome. Oh yeah, that better be in the game. How to Train Your Dragon, cool. Dragon-based rail shooter. What?
Konnichiwa.
Hello, I'm Shinya Takahashi from Nintendo. Earlier this month, we held a Pokemon Direct for the latest games in the series, Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield.
Woo-loo!
The developers from Game Freak showcased the new Galar region, the location of your new adventure, and some new Pokemon you'll encounter there.
Woo-loo!
It will be a while until these games launch, so please stay tuned. By the way, in these games, you can use certain functions of the Pokeball Plus accessory, allowing you to take a Pokemon from one of these games out for a stroll through the real world with you.
Grookey, that's its name.
You may not be able to use the device as a game controller, but if you spend some quality... with a favorite Pokemon of yours, then something good might happen. In the Nintendo booth at this year's E3, fans can play Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield for the first time anywhere in the world.
Cool.
In this gameplay demo, you can challenge one of the gyms in the Galar region, the one and only Water Gym, where the Water-type gym leader Nessa will be there waiting for you. If you're attending this year's show, I encourage you to experience a battle between Dynamax Pokémon, which is an advanced strategy from this region. Also, immediately after this Nintendo Direct,
a demo?
Stay tuned for live gameplay of Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield on Nintendo Treehouse Live. And now I'd like to shift gears. Please have a look at this.
It's a weird direction for a Pokemon game to take.
I've been waiting for you. As you know,
okay, here's the game
currently under extra-dimensional attack. Chimeras, like the ones you've just seen for the first time. At this rate, all of humankind will be pulled into the Chimeras dimension. We're facing down the end of the world. Through blood, sweat, and years of research, we finally made it. The ultimate counter-chimeric weapon. By neurologically syncing captured chimeras with human operators, we established control and made powerful allies. I'm referring, of course, to the Legions.
I'll give you some parting advice. Your power. It's not the blessing you think it is.
When a Legionis and a Legion are perfectly synchronized, it's like they're two parts of one body.
No use! The override release isn't going through!
That's impossible!
And when half of that body is about to die, the Legion's survival instincts kick in to save it.
No way! There's no way! What good could this possibly be?
It's a long shot, but it's the only shot we have! It's all up to you, my friend.
A blessing from the Legion. Or maybe I should say, a curse. We can't turn back now. I've gotta know the whole truth. He's still alive out there. I know he is.
Chain. Oh, cool. Oh. Oh, wait, no, that was the game, okay. Like, are we getting it?
Death by our hands is not an honor they have earned. They deserve something much worse.
Even with this stone at my command, this may not be a battle we can win.
Whatever's happening, we can beat it. Keep fighting.
Whoa, we got Miss Marvel in this one. Nice.
Jump in anytime now, darlings.
Yeah.
They will pay for what they've done in blood. All hope is fleeting in the face of Thanos.
Thank you.
like how the designs of these Avengers look a lot better than the Avengers. Not the MCU Avengers, the Avengers games. Marvel Knights, X-Men, Fantastic Four. Oh! Cool. Oh, right, right, right. Legend of Zelda Rhythm game RPG thing. Cadence Fire. There we go. Wow, that's just a couple days away. We're really already advertising Tokyo. Whoa, that's new. You know what? These games sell extraordinarily well, so I'm not surprised.
So, what do you think so far? Now for some follow-up information on a game that fans have been waiting for.
Please, here we go.
Take a look.
Show me that Samus.
Your attention, please. The Nook Inc. Getaway Package charter flight will soon be arriving at the deserted island.
Oh. There you go, kids. This looks so cute. I made a flimsy axe. This doesn't look half bad, actually. Oh, that's cool. Crossing New Horizons. There you go. March 2020. I thought that was going to be her letter.
Originally,
for Smash.
We announced this title as a 2019 release. However, we need to change its release date to March 20th of 2020.
That's fair.
To ensure that the game is the best it can be, we must ask you to wait a little longer than we thought. We hope you look forward to the latest installment of Animal Crossing. On Nintendo Treehouse Live, the game's producer, Mr. Nogami, and the director, Ms. Kyogoku, will come on for a live demonstration of some early moments in the game, so please stick around until it starts. By the way, there are many different types of games coming to Nintendo Switch from Nintendo and our partners. So, we've prepared a highlight reel to show you what's in store for 2019 and beyond. Let's have a look.
All right, here's everything that we didn't want to put in trailer for. Yes! All right, is it actually going to be the full friggin' games? Minecraft Dungeons, they announced that a couple days ago. Or yesterday, I think. Elder Scrolls Blades. My friend Pedro. Doom Eternal, cool. Alien Isolate, wow! Confirmed for the Wii. Super low. What? Oh, yeah, the Microsoft deal. Okay. That's cool. Mario Maker 2, yeah. Are we missing someone? No! Are you guys kidding me now? Banjo kids! Are you kidding me? Oh. No. No, it's definitely them. Are you fucking kidding me? There you go. If I do like a, he's got projectiles, he can use Kazooie, that's amazing. Oh my god. I did not think this would happen. Fall 2019. Okay. So we're getting Dragon Quest the summer.
That obviously wasn't Duck Hunt's silhouette, was it? Please stay tuned for more information about DLC in the future. As for Nintendo Switch, we have more games in development beyond what we've shown you today. I'm looking forward to the day we can introduce them to you. Speaking of, before we end this direct, I actually have one more thing to show you. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.
Prime. Here we go. go, here we go. Not prime.
What?
This isn't DLC. Guys, this isn't DLC. What? Sorry. Ooh, that was good. Oh my God. Okay. It's gonna take years.
Hey, good morning, everybody.
Hey, good morning, Doug. Wow. All right, let's get some music on again. Oh man. I didn't think we were gonna get that. I honestly didn't think we were gonna get that. Wow. Wow. Okay, like, I don't want to go into, like, full trailer analytics here, but... or analysis. That was Ganon's corpse. Right? That was his, like, corpse coming back to life. That wasn't Calamity Ganon. That was Ganondorf. Wow. Yeah, Nintendo knows how to do this. Tamper fanboyism. Ganon's a freaking re-dead, yes. Ooh. Oh my God. Wow. I'm blown away. I didn't think we would be getting that info this early. Unless they are, like, far enough into development where they can say, like, maybe by next E3 it's going to be like a winter 2020 release. But that seems too soon. Yeah. God. Banjo for Smash. Oh man. I'm going to go back at the beginning of the stream and say, like, somebody's going to say, like, oh yeah, you said, like, oh, you don't think it's going to happen because it's rare, but yeah, you never know. But what do I know? It just means, like, three more. No. Joker was the first one. We're getting Hero from Dragon Quest is the second one. Banjo is the third one. We need two more Smash characters announced. still haven't beaten Breath of the Wild. Dude, do it. It is... I don't want to say that it's my favorite Zelda game. It fluctuates between that and Wind Waker. Wow. Sora's partially owned by Disney. That means we're gonna get the Rare Rewind on Switch. That's going to be a direct that we get later this year. That says, oh yeah, we're getting the Rare Rewind. Nintendo now has a working relationship with Microsoft. Microsoft owns Rare. We're getting Rare games back on Nintendo consoles. It's only a matter of time. I did not see the Frozen 2 trailer. I'm going to do it after the stream. Wow. Oh my god, that was a ride. How long have we been going for? Hour and 12. Needless to say, I am shooketh. I'm gonna take everything in this direct with a grain of salt, especially that last one. The Smash DLC? No. Like, that's definitely gonna happen. In development. So... I don't know. Wow. Wowie, wowie, wow. Oh my god. We're getting a direct sequel to Breath of the Wild. That to me means more than like a new remaster of like Link's Awakening, or even if we get like re-releases of Twilight Princess and Wind Waker on the Switch. I don't think that's gonna happen. But damn. Wow, that was pretty good. I don't know how to compare this to previous directs or previous E3s. This may have been the best one since 2010. This may be the best one since 2010. When they announced, like, the Donkey Kong Returns. Donkey Kong Country Returns. And Kid Icarus Uprising. And... oh my god. Yeah, the castle is moving. Link's moving castle. I get it. Oh, God. Well, I just wanted to... well, originally, I thought of setting up a sort of like... post Nintendo gaming stream, but I couldn't get my SNES Classic to work on here because apparently I either don't know how to hook up my HD PVR Rocket to this thing through OBS. Ganon's moving cat. There we go. We got there. Either don't know how to hook up my PVR Rocket to this thing, or like it's not supported anymore, or I'm just dumb. So, it was just going to be this stream. So, wow. Hour, 15 minutes of stream. Like, that. All right. I'm going to call it here. So, wow. All right. Enjoy the rest of your day, everyone, with the knowledge that we are getting Breath of the Wild, a sequel to Breath of the Wild. Banjo's in Smash. Banjo-Kazooie are in Smash. And what that means for the future of Nintendo. Honestly, that's a lot better than Minecraft, Steve. To be perfectly honest. I'm so happy that we're getting him over Minecraft, Steve. Yeah. Wow. Just wow. I don't have anything else to say. Yeah, so thanks everyone for stopping by. Bonus nachos, kids. Damn. That was good. That was really, really good. All right, I'm gonna stop talking now.